Welcome back to Computer Vision. This lesson is going to start a whole unit on motion. Now, in the real world, things really move. You know, trees blow in the wind, boats move along the water, a baseball player swings his bat and typically misses if he plays for the Mets. But, you know, things are moving all the time, and our perception system handles them. In computer vision, we also want to deal with motion, but what's kind of cool is actually nothing is moving. What you're seeing here is a repeated GIF image, and I've made it sort of coarsely sampled, actually from some slides stolen from some folks listed below, so that you can see that it's actually a sequence of static frames, okay? And, you know, of course, the issue is that when we look at them, when they're not so separated in time by quite so much, we see this nice motion. And what we would like is that the same perception of motion that we have, we'd like to be able to give a machine. We'd like a machine to be able to understand the notion of motion, if you will. So when we're going to talk about motion, here we're going to start talking about video. Now, really, we're just thinking about a sequence of frames. And in fact, a long time ago, we used to just call them sequences because a camera would go, and then a camera would take another picture, and then sometime later it would take another picture, and the question was how to use those. These days, of course, much more ubiquitous is a notion of video where a sequence is captured over time, usually relatively quickly, so things can't change a whole lot from one sequence sample to the next, and usually taken at regular intervals, whether it's every 30 hertz, 60 hertz, 24 hertz. The idea is that it's at regular intervals. Now, our image is no longer a function of just space, x and y, but our image is a function of space, x, y, and time, t. So our signal is I of x, y, and t. But as I said before, sometimes when we describe them as a three-dimensional function like this, we tend to think of all three dimensions as being the same, but they're not. Space is quite different than time. So if I were wearing a nice checkered shirt instead of this gorgeous green, as I moved in space, you would see pixels changing very quickly in terms of their intensity or their color. But if I were to change the pixels that quickly in time, you would essentially see a mess. You would see all this flickering and things changing very rapidly. So in general, even though we think of these as a three-dimensional function, remember that time and space are different in terms of their statistics.